So as you're in the hospital, on your back, screaming in pain, your wife will be on her back, screaming my name. So this goes to all my freaks out there. Big Papa Pump is your hookup. Holler if you hear me.
What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, the Executioner. And if you don't know, now you know. And off here to my right is my esteemed co-host, Almanac Jack. He's on the attack, and you can't teach that. What's going on, Jack?
What's going on, Executioner? And what's going on, everybody out there listening to another episode of Good Times. That's right. This is the Good Times podcast where there's good laughs, good fun, and it's always a good time.
Damn right.
New shows come out every Thursday, so don't forget to subscribe, rate, review, and tell a friend. Executioner, if they're telling the friend where to find the show, what do they tell them?
Oh, man. All you have to do is just send a text, send an email, send a carrier pigeon, any of that bullshit. Maybe send a message over MySpace. I don't know. All you got to do is go to thegoodtimespodcast.com. where you can find all of our podcasts available on all streaming platforms and all that good stuff. You can also go to Twitter at It's Good Times, and you can find us on there. You can find us on Instagram at TheGoodTimesPodcast.com. Why?
There's no dot that they would let us put in there.
Suck a dick dot. And you can also go to Facebook, where you can find us at The Good Times Podcast, and you can find us on there as well. So, yeah. How you doing, Mr. Jack?
I am doing good as Jack Cheese. I don't know if Jack Cheese is doing good, but it tastes good. So we'll just go with that.
Well, if he's a person, then I've been gay this whole time.
Imagine there's a guy with his driver's license right now. His name is Jack Cheese.
Oh, my God.
Or if he's Mexican, he's Jack Queso. How you doing, man?
Oh, man, I'm good. Just came off that three-day weekend.
Yeah, that's right. We're recording this after Memorial Day.
Yes. Shout out to all the fallen soldiers, as well as everybody that's done service in the service.
Yep.
And for your time for helping us out. And I don't want to go into the politics of it, but yeah, you catch my drift.
Yeah. You know, I always got a Memorial Day and Labor Day mixed up, of like which one's, you know, before summer, which one's after summer. I just knew it was a day off of school, so I was like, yes.
I mean, honestly, you're not wrong. I still don't know what is the difference? Do you know, is there like a difference? Like,
yeah, well, Memorial Day's for veterans. Labor Day's that's right. Fucking we're working. It's work day, but we're getting the day off of work. So I don't know. I don't know who makes these holidays.
I don't know.
Fuck it. Day off from school back when I was a kid. So I'm good.
Yeah. I work federally, so I get the day off and I get paid. So
yeah, you get all of them. Yeah, you're good.
I get all the good stuff.
Yeah. Hey, okay. I'm going to go back to last week a little bit. For everybody who listened to the show, you might remember that we had like a power outage.
Oh, yeah. And
there was a storm at the time. But see, the weird thing was is that only Executioner's computer station went down. Not anything else. His TV was still on, his PlayStation was still on, basically everything was still good except for where we were recording. And you had told me that you had some kind of like weird stuff going on after I had left.
Yeah.
So and I made you like not tell me so like you could tell it on the show. So you mind telling it on the show?
Yeah. So shit. It was kind of crazy. Like, so just a little premise again, what he said, you know, we were just obviously doing the show. That's why the first hour of last week's recording was like a little weird and a little bit off. It was just our backup recording that I have, because I always have a backup recording going just in case stuff like that, this happens.
Yep.
So basically as he said, we were sitting here, the power bank goes off and that was it. It was kind of weird. And we were also talking about like a lot of like Mandela effect stuff at the time. So a little bit later, I think it was the next day. It was the next day. I'm literally laying here on my bed watching, I was watching this Netflix show called You. I don't know if you've ever seen it before.
No.
It's about a stalker. It's pretty crazy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's cool. But okay, so I'm like literally laying here watching and my door's closed. And all of a sudden, my door handle just like kind of just, and my door opens.
Did you hear it turn?
Yeah, like I heard it like pretty much just shh, and then it like opened up. And I was like, what the fuck? Because usually, because here's my thing. I mean, I grew up with three sisters. So my thing is, if I'm closing my door, it's closed.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not half-assing it, just like, oh, whatever. No. If I'm putting in the effort to close my door, it is closed. There's just no reason for me to leave it creaked open or just barely. No, it's always closed. And like I seen it open and I'm like, what the fuck? And basically in the hallway, there's no windows in the hallway.
Mm-hmm.
The other door's closed and there's only a downstairs. And I turn on my light on my phone. I'm just literally sitting on my bed, laying on my bed. And I just start kind of pointing it towards like the door to see if anybody's there. Cause I'm just waiting for like one of my sisters to come in like, hey, I need to use the bathroom or I need to use like the shower or whatever.
Yeah.
And but they usually knock. I mean, they've always knocked. So then I was like even more confused. So then I ended up getting up and just like walking over there and nothing. There's literally nothing there.
What the heck?
And so, and another kind of crazy thing too, is that like usually when I feel like spirits around or anything, my ears will start ringing. Like, not like one ear starts ringing, you know, like when they say people are talking about you or something like that.
Yeah.
No, like I get like this ringing in like the back of my head almost. And it kind of feels like it just kind of feels like it just comes from like the, like around my head almost. It's kind of like a,
like
weird,
a, like a pressure or what?
No, not pressure. It just feels like it's like,
or like static maybe?
Like behind me almost.
Okay.
It feels like, yeah, it feels like it's like, like behind me. It doesn't feel like it's coming from like directly in my ear. It just feels like it's like something's there.
Okay.
So I've always kind of like, and I've had my run in with spirits and stuff like that in the past. And so that night, like one of the things that I actually kind of struggle with my heart and whatnot, if I lay like a certain way, like, and I end up like laying on like on my side a little bit too much, and I like crush my chest, like I'll lose a lot of oxygen, and so when I wake up, I'll see shit.
And, really?
Yeah.
Like what kind of stuff?
Oh, dude, it's so weird to describe it because it to me it's like I feel like it's like a silhouette of shit, like random shit.
Huh.
Like I feel like I see something there, and then I'm like, what the fuck? And I look, and it's gone. But like to me, I'm like, I know it's not real. You know what I mean? Like, or sometimes like I'll see my chair like move like a little bit, and then I'm like, it didn't move because it's still in the same spot. Like, you know, it's just like little things like that. But that night, dude, it was like even more so than usual. Like, like I have this Bone Thugs poster up on my door right here on the back of it.
And the same one that's been on like every door you've ever had.
The dopest poster, man. You know I love Bone Thugs. Shout out to Bone Thugs. I ain't listening, but it's all good. but like that night, like I kind of saw it almost looked like where it was black, because it's like a black and red poster. It's like an all black poster with Bone Thugs and Harmony logo on it in red. It was like anything that was black, it looked like it was smoky. And like the letters were just kind of like popping out.
Hmm.
And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, and I'm like looking at it. And I'm looking at it, and I'm, like, trying to, like, what the fuck? And I don't smoke. I just want everybody to know that right now. They're like, oh, this guy's on drugs. Like,
so, yeah, this guy doesn't do anything.
Yeah, I don't. Like, literally the only thing I do is CBD, and that's not even, like, you know, anything that'll...
And whatever you take for your heart.
Give you a head change. Yeah, and that shit, too. But, yeah, it was, like, that whole night, I woke up, like, 4 or 5 times, and, like, I felt like I kept seeing shit. Next day, it wasn't as bad. I only woke up a couple times thinking that I saw shit. And after that, it just kind of went away. And I was like, dude, like, it was so fucking weird. Like, And then, oh, another thing too is that like a day or so later, my sisters, they're downstairs, and all of a sudden the front door just flies open.
What the heck?
Yeah, the front door just flies open, and that's all that happens.
Was it closed?
It was closed. But even if it wasn't closed, the door just doesn't open up. Like, I did the same thing with my door to see, like try to debunk it, like try to see, like, if I put it in a certain place or something like that. No, like, you could try it yourself. Even if it's, like, kind of closed, it's not opening. And when it does, it didn't open up the way that it did, like, that night. And it's just so weird, dude. That so weird. Fucking weird.
Maybe there's a, like, a residual spirit.
I think there is, dude. Honestly. You know,
it's not a harmful spirit. It's just, like, a spirit that constantly goes through the same thing. And maybe it's just, like, a spirit that just walks through doors. Like, that's its, you know, residual effect.
I mean, maybe. I mean, another thing, too, is that I live in an apartment, so, you know, there can be spirits really anywhere in the apartments. You know what I mean?
Like, sure. Or whatever people bring with them when they move in.
Right. And you know what I also just noticed, too, is that the people next to us just moved out this week or, like, a couple days ago or something like that.
Was it because of that shooting?
I don't know why it was, but it was... Because there was some people that moved out because of the shooting, but the people next to us, they just like randomly moved out, and I'm just thinking like maybe if they were moving a bunch of stuff, maybe it could have triggered something, you know what I mean? Like, because that happens a lot, like when you start renovating a house, when you start moving a lot of shit around,
yeah,
you know, then spirits become a little bit active. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why at like some haunted places, you'll see them go through walls. It's like, oh, you do some research. Turns out there was a door there, and then now they patched up with a wall. So they're used to there being a door, but now there's a wall, so it looks, you know, trippy.
Oh, I actually didn't know that.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty cool. I never really thought of that.
I really like paranormal stuff, like ghosts and all that.
Same.
I've never encountered anything or felt anything.
Lucky you.
But like, you know, I watch a lot of ghost stuff, read up on it and stuff, so like, you know, I'm knowledgeable in it, but I've just never experienced it.
Yeah. Maybe the way you get to experience it is if you go to like an actual fucking like haunted hotel or some shit.
That's what I was thinking. It's like, maybe if I go to like the Queen Mary or, you know, like Winchester House or something like that.
Yeah.
You know, maybe. But I mean, like around here, I don't think so. Like, I don't think I'm as sensitive to it as other people. My mom is really sensitive to it.
Yeah.
It seems like every girl in my family is really sensitive to it.
I mean,
when I think about it, my cousins.
I always think that it's kind of like a genetic thing almost.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like a genetic sensitivity.
Yeah. Like my mom. Okay. Her mom was sensitive to this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
My mom is. Her sister is. And then both of my cousins from my mom's sister, they're sensitive to that stuff. But like all the dudes, you know, me, my brother, and you know, my cousin, we're really not. So it must be just like a genetic thing to the women on our side where they're sensitive to it. And my cousin, she's seen some crazy shit.
Oh.
She's had some crazy shit happen to her at her house.
Ooh.
And basically everywhere that she's lived, she's had something crazy happen to her.
Probably attached to her.
And maybe one of these days we'll get her on the show just to like share them. Cause I don't want to like tell them and like get stuff wrong.
Yeah, dude.
You know, like I don't want to tell her story and get it wrong, and then like she comes on and tells it, and it's like, what the fuck did you say? You know,
dude, that'd be so badass, dude. We should just have a fucking episode of paranormal shit.
Fuck yeah, I'm down. My cousins, I'll see. Maybe we won't be able to get them at the same time, but fuck it, we'll record them separate and just to tell their stories, and then you know, I'm sure your sister or your mom has some crazy shit too.
Oh, so. Dude, a lot of people in my family have like been through a lot of shit, dude. Like, my grandma went through a lot of shit, too, like, seen a lot of shit. It really, I mean, I think it more so has to do with they haunt women and girls because it's just easy, like, for them, you know what I mean? Because they don't really have, like, the same masculine guard as, like, a guy does, you know? Like, I know you said you haven't, like, really encountered anything, but have you ever had it when you've just heard, like, a random noise or, like, a random... something randomly falls over or something like that? Like,
nothing to fall over. Noises, sure, but I usually debunk that myself. Like, I'm kind of like hesitant to be like, oh, it was a spirit.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah, of course.
I'm a really big debunker. Like, I know houses creak, my cousin's house used to creak all the time, like randomly in the middle of the night, like the roof would creak or
you know,
like a wall would creak or something like that.
It's about to fall in.
For real. When I was when I was little one time and it was like thunderstorming, it was creaking and I was like, oh my God, the roof's going to fall. I'm going to get struck by lightning. A tornado's going to fly me away.
There's a volcano coming right now.
We need volcano insurance. But yeah, you know, I debunk stuff. I felt something touch me one time when I was working at Denny's while I was back in the kitchen. But like, I was just like real quick to be like, oh, like I probably just ran into the garbage can because, you know, it's got the handle on the side. So I was just like, oh, I probably just ran into the garbage can. Plus it was on wheels too. So, I mean, fuck it. I could have hit it with, you know, something and then that, it hit me or rolled or whatever. But
yeah, yeah.
I'm just a big debunker where I'm just like, yeah, maybe it was this instead of jumping to the conclusion that it was a spirit.
Well, yeah, I understand that. But one thing that you should probably do, you should probably ask a long leg daddy about that, Denny's. Maybe he's felt something or he, you know what I mean? Like, maybe he's experienced something or he knows people that experienced stuff over there. Because restaurants are like that. Like,
yeah.
I have some pretty good stories about when I worked at Schoolhouse Restaurant that I could definitely share. And I'll save those for, like, our paranormal ones because those are really good. Okay. So
I'll ask him if I ever get the chance to.
Yeah, if he ever gets a chance.
Say if he ever gets a chance to tell me. Well, let's shift gears here from the paranormal stuff because I don't want to spill any stories.
Yeah,
that'll ruin a future episode.
There's so much.
Yeah. How about this? Have you noticed? Okay, obviously, like, homelessness is a pretty big problem in the city, and it's kind of growing everywhere, really. I mean, not just here, basically everywhere. You know how they're trying to do the whole, like, raise minimum wage to $15 and all that stuff?
Yeah.
I think that's, like, spilling over into the bum community now.
Oh, shit.
Because,
they're not asking for a dollar. They're asking for $5.
How did you know?
Are they really?
Dude, that happened to me today.
Holy shit.
Yeah, okay, so it used to be back in the day, you'd go to the store, the liquor store, and on your way out, there'd be a bum there, and he'd just be like, hey, you know, you got like a quarter, you know, you got, you know, just a handful of change or whatever like that, and,
yeah,
you know, you'd have like a couple dimes and a penny, and you'd be like, here you go, fucker, take it. but now, maybe like within the past couple of years, it's been like, hey, do you got a dollar? You know, like, can I have a dollar? Like, they just come straight up and tell you, can I have a dollar? You know, they don't even say, like, can I have some change?
Yeah, yeah.
Today, no lie, dude, I'm sitting in my car, and I'm waiting to go into work, and this bum lady comes out from nowhere, and I made the mistake of having my windows down. this bum lady comes, and she's like, excuse me. And I'm like, what the fuck? She's like, you got $5? I'm like, what? You got $5 I can have? I'm like, nah, sorry. And she's all like, oh, we got any change that I can have? And I'm like, no, sorry, I can't help you today. And she just goes on and she's like, you know, mumbling bum stuff. You know, bums just mumble when they walk.
Mumble.
So she's just walking around just. So, like, seriously, bums now are taking into account inflation and the raise of wages to where they're asking for $5 a piece.
Holy shit.
Yeah, bitch, I don't even got $5. What the fuck?
I don't even, like, loan my sisters $5, let alone you. What the fuck?
I know, right? Fucking lady, dude.
That's fucking crazy. $5.
$5, dude. Like, straight up, like, wants a $5 bill.
Damn.
What are the bums coming to?
They're just trying to get that ice cream, man. There's some
ice cream. Get the fuck out of here. Shit,
you know what I mean? Like, trying to get some of that. Trying to get some of that baking soda. You know what I mean? That baking powder, soda. Man.
Some of that codeine.
Yeah.
Something.
Some of that cough syrup. Trying to get that NyQuil in there.
Oh, yeah, I don't know, dude. But
$5 NyQuil.
Fucking buns, dude. But
and the $5 ones, the 2-pack. So maybe they are trying to get that NyQuil.
Stop giving the people ideas. So we'll go from, I got another story from my other job. So we'll go from one crazy person to another. This one's about the crazy guy at work that yells a lot.
Okay.
The one that I told you, like, you know, tried to fight me.
Yeah, yeah.
So he's outside, and I'm in one of the apartments with my client, and he's yelling and stuff, and I could hear him from, you know, outside the door. So, you know, I open the front door and poke my head out and see what's going on, and he's yelling at one of the staff there. He's like, "Shut up, bitch! Shut the fuck up, bitch! I'll fuck you up, bitch! Shut up, bitch!" And so then she's just like, "You ain't gonna do anything. Just go back inside the house, whatever." So then there's, you know, still big puddles of water there because of all the rain. And yeah. I guess he starts like scooping up water with the cup and throwing it on people.
What?
Throwing it on the staff. What? So and I don't know why all the staff decided to just fucking stay outside. So there's like four girls maybe? And they're just standing outside and he's throwing it at them and they're running away. So one of the girls comes and runs to my apartment that I'm at with another girl. And then the other girl ends up, you know, going back, but the other girl stayed. And I'm like, "Well, what's going on?" He's like, "Oh, he's throwing water on people and he already threw water on so-and-so."
What the fuck?
And I look at who he threw water on, big old fucking puddle right on the side of her leg, you know, where he splashed her and shit. And so then she's telling me what's going on and whatever. And then she's like, "Okay, I'm going to go back." So she goes back, and as soon as she starts walking over there, that fool picks up another cup of water and starts like running towards people, ready to throw it on them.
What the fuck?
And so then she comes back inside, and she's like, "Well, I'm going to just stay here for a while he's, you know, fucking around or whatever." But then the best part, dude, is I go sit down back at the table that I was sitting at, and I'm writing down my notes, and she's standing at the door with the door open, and she's just looking outside. And all I hear is him yelling at one of the staff girls, "You're going to die, bitch. You're going to fucking die, bitch. I'm going to wet you with this cup, bitch." Holy and everything shit. That everything that he said would end with bitch. And dude, it made me laugh so hard because I was like, dude, this dude sounds just like a fucking cartoon character. And he's like, "You gonna die, bitch, and you gonna die, bitch," and he's pointing at each one, okay? And so he's like, "You gonna die, bitch," and then he's like, "And Angie's gonna die, bitch," and Angie's like one of the office ladies. And he's like, "And she's gonna die, bitch, and fucking everybody's gonna die, bitch." He just stops and has to think about it. He's going down the list of who's gonna die, and he ran out of people. Everybody's gonna die, bitch.
I forgot your name. You're gonna die too,
bitch. I'm surprised he didn't start yelling at the cats walking by, because there's a lot of cats in the neighborhood.
So funny. He's all, "Puffy, you're gonna die, bitch.
Actually, one
Majestic,
of the
names, you're gonna die,
bitch." One of the names of the cats is Patches.
Patches of who, him?
That's what Janet calls him all the time.
She's gonna die too, bitch.
I really wanted to record him just so I could have you listen to it, but
oh my god!
But yeah, I didn't want to get near him. I didn't want to get wet.
Either that, or you just didn't want to get called a bitch,
bitch. Oh well, shit. He's called me much worse. I mean, he tried to fight me.
But... Oh, that's right. He tried to get in your car and shit.
Yeah, and I just told him, I was like, "I'm gonna run your ass over, dude. Get out of the way, bitch." Okay.
Holy shit.
So I know you've been dying to tell me this story about Blockbuster.
Oh yeah.
So go ahead.
All right. So I stumbled upon this article last week, I believe, and I was supposed to tell it on the podcast for last week, and I completely forgot. And so here we are now. So obviously,
remembering.
Here we are now, remembering. So do you remember Blockbuster?
Of course.
And how often did you go to Blockbuster?
Oh, not that often, but enough to, you know, remember stuff about it.
So were you a Blockbuster? Oh my god, Blockbuster. Were you a Blockbuster guy or a Hollywood Videos guy?
Honestly, I'd probably be more of a Hollywood Video guy.
Same here. My dad would go to Hollywood Videos all the damn time. I would get so many games over there too.
Game Crazy.
Yes, Game Crazy. Yep. Yeah. Yep. That was like the best part of Hollywood Videos. And I don't know how widespread Hollywood Videos was. Maybe it was just like a Fresno thing or...
No, it had to be more than that.
Maybe, yeah. But I remember Hollywood Videos going out of style and, you know, getting shut down. I was like, fuck, man. Like, I've only been to Blockbuster like once or twice, and it was just never felt the same, you know? It never felt like this homey place of... you know, like fucking Hollywood videos did. Yeah. I still remember one night. So my brother and my dad, they share the same name, and my dad had, you know, his membership. So my brother would go in there all the time and give him my dad's membership, and they'd be like, okay, you're all good. Your name's Richard Hernandez, whatever, you know, and they just let him go. But one of the times it was the manager. So the manager's like, okay, let me see your ID. And they're like, this says Richard Hernandez, and yours says Richard Hernandez III. So we can't let you get this. He's like, are you fucking serious? He's like, I come here all the time. Like, why does the third all of a sudden matter? Like, it's my account, you know?
Yeah.
And they're all like, no, we just can't let you do it. He's all, are you fucking kidding me? And he starts getting all fucking mad. And then he just starts yelling, fuck this place. Fuck you, bitch. Fuck, blah, blah.
Fuck starts, you, bitch, bitch.
So he's like going off. And then I remember, like, I'm just like trying not to like laugh because I thought it was like really funny. And so like we walk outside and there's like a trash can, dude. And dude, this trash can had so much shit in it, so much cigarette butts on it, like all kinds of shit. And then he just like kicked it over, dude. He kicked it over, and there was just like, you know how there's the sand and stuff like that for the cigarette butt. All the sand's on the floor, all kinds of cigarette butts are on the floor, there's all kinds of trash. And we just got in the car and we left, dude. I was like, fuck. And I was pissed too, because, man, I forgot what I was gonna rent that night, but it was a good game. It was a WWE game, but yeah,
SmackDown versus Raw.
Probably. Here no, comes the I pain. I always bought those games.
Oh.
It was like it was like the fucking car games that they had. The fucking when they made like a WWE in Twisted Metal type of shit. Game. It was games like that, like the little knockoff games.
Yeah, not
like that.
Not the main series ones.
Yeah, no, yeah, I always bought those.
hey, you know what's crazy? You mentioned the ashtray thing spilling over and cigarette butts everywhere.
Yeah.
Have you noticed, going back to bums are picking up fucking cigarette butts off the floor all the time now?
No.
Dude, I see that shit all the time.
Are they like saving them?
They're smoking them.
Whoa.
They're picking them up and like relighting them and smoking them.
Whoa.
Remember that story I told about the bum with the stick?
Yeah.
Yeah, where he's like, give me that stick! that guy. He was walking in the middle of the street. He found a cigarette butt, and he picked that shit up, and he took out a lighter, and he started smoking it.
Holy shit.
I mean, that explains why he's crazy, but well, partly. But, dude, I don't know why bums pick up leftover cigarette butts like that.
I mean,
That's just how you get the HEPA HERPA HIV.
Yeah, the HEPA HERPA HIV for the nicotina, you know?
Yeah.
Trying to get that nicotina fucking in your bums, man. I don't know. It's crazy, man. But anyways, after all that, back to Blockbuster.
Yeah.
So, as I said, I stumbled upon an article that was talking about the last Blockbuster left in the world.
There's still one?
There is one left.
No way.
Yes.
Where? So,
there was two of them. The first one was, one of them was in Australia,
uh-huh.
And the other one was in Oregon.
Oregon?
So, the one in Australia just closed down a couple months ago. And there's only one left.
Last of the Mohicans.
In Bend, Oregon.
Bend?
It's called Bend. The city's called Bend.
Oh, that was going to be like Bend Over.
Bend Over, Oregon. So as it was saying here, the Australian one was the last one. This is the most previous one to close down, leaving this one the only one left. And the craziest part is that it's actually independently owned. It's not even owned by Blockbuster anymore.
Wow.
Yeah, it's not even owned by Blockbuster anymore. They're like, fuck you guys. Like, you know.
They must be doing all right then.
Yeah, so that's what I was going to talk about too. So so it's kind of crazy because, you know, obviously there's not a lot of demand for DVDs and Blu-rays and all that
DVDs.
DVDs. You know, not really, you know, but there's a nostalgia factor with Blockbuster.
Sure.
And last week, I guess. Oh, sorry, not last week. But basically, one of the crazy things was, you know, people are. It's like a tourist thing now. People are like going in and signing up for accounts just to get a Blockbuster card,
just to say they have one,
just to say they have
one. Wow, that's cool.
They get 10 new accounts a day.
What?
Yes.
Wow.
10 new accounts a day. And it's kind of crazy because there's a there's a let's see here. All right, there's a resident business in Oregon, and it's like basically rallied around the store, and it's a brewery. It's called the 10 Barrel Brewing, and they actually crafted a beer for them, and they call it the Last Blockbuster.
Uh huh.
And so that was like one of the things too, is that, you know, this is the Last Blockbuster, and they're doing everything they can. And it's, like I said, it's basically a tourist attraction at this point. And it's like, it's so fucking crazy because they like, they're still going strong. They still got so much going on. There's still, you know, some employees there. And like one of the things too, is that they have a Twitter. So the Twitter is called the last Blockbuster. And basically whoever runs this Twitter is basically just making fun of their own store, like in certain ways. So like just this last tweet that they put out 2 days ago, it says, "We're closed tomorrow in honor of those who served and also because of the bugs." So just like,
oh my God.
So just like dumb shit like that. Like,
yeah.
Let's see here. Let's see.
That's crazy, dude. That there's still a Blockbuster left.
Dude, there's one Blockbuster left.
Speaking of Blockbuster, that was from the Amanda Show.
Yeah, Blockbuster.
Welcome to Blockbuster. It's better. Much better.
So this one says, it's a poll. It says, "We're changing our slogan. Which is your favorite?" The first one, it's Cinemagic. Number two, "Don't stream, dream." The third one, "Please." And the fourth one, "Movies you can hold."
I like "please." Because you can use "please" anyway. Blockbuster. Please.
And this one here says, we never would have allowed the Girl Scouts to set up a table out front if we knew that they weren't actually Girl Scouts.
Hey, those Girl Scout cookies are hella good, though.
Hell yeah, they're the shit.
What's your favorite one?
The coconut one? No, the peanut butter ones.
The peanut butter patties?
Peanut butter coconut ones or something like
coconut?
That.
Coconut? Ew!
I think that's
like... No coconut.
I don't remember that. What are the flavors again?
There's peanut butter patties. There's wackadoos and whack-a-moths and I don't know.
And vermicious canids and
yeah, the snozzberries,
the hornswoggles, and yeah, good old vermicious canids.
I just know the peanut butter patties because that's what I get all the time.
The peanut butter patties. Oh, the Samoas.
Oh, the Samoas?
Yes.
Those are the coconut ones, right?
Yes. Yeah. Those are the fucking best, dude.
It's the one time I don't like the Samoans.
The one time I don't like Samoans. Holy yeah. Shit.
What other ones do they have?
Oh shit, I was just looking it up and I damn it.
You just looked up Girl Scout coconut.
Sorry, let me pull this back up. There is s'mores.
Ew.
There is the Thin Mints.
Okay, I guess.
The Samoas again.
Ew.
Peanut butter patties.
Fuck yeah.
The Tagalongs.
What's that?
I guess a peanut butter patty. More layers of peanut butter inside cookie.
Oh, okay. Fuck yeah.
There's the peanut butter sandwich, the dosey, which is also the basically the dosey dough. It's a little bit different. Shortbread, the tray foils, the lemonades. That looks weird. It's literally a cookie with the imprint of a lemon on it, like a slice of a lemon.
That's how you know it's bad. Because, you know, you ever get those like generic candies and it's just got like the picture of like a cherry on it.
Yeah.
But it's like, it tastes like a fucking cough drop.
Oh, that's the worst. And then there's the Savannah Smiles.
The fuck is that?
It's the crisp lemony cookies dusted with powdered sugar.
Ew. That sounds even worse than the lemon head ones.
Holy shit.
Give me the peanut butter patty one. That's it.
Yeah, I feel you on that. But also, I was going to go back to Blockbuster for a second. So, it was kind of crazy.
Tangents.
It's kind of crazy because the video store chain is part of the Netflix origin story.
What?
Founder and CEO Reed Hastings frequently mentions that he started the business originally a subscription package for DVD rentals because he was charged a $40 late fee for Apollo 13. That's what you get for watching fake shit. He said, I rented a VHS, misplaced it, and it was 6 weeks late. Hastings said in 2006 interview, I remember it because I didn't want to tell my wife. And so, let me see here, because...
He's afraid to tell his wife that he owed $40.
Yeah.
What a bitch.
So, if I remember this correctly, I think it was Netflix and Blockbuster. I'm trying to see if I can find this shit. Damn it. No. I mean, if I remember it correctly, there was a story about somebody was supposed to buy Netflix early on and they didn't. And they were like, no, it's not good enough or whatever. And I think it was Blockbuster that was supposed to, that they had offered it to, and they just never, they just didn't take it.
And now they're that sounds about right.
And also, like, the last thing about Blockbuster is, like, the different things that they have over at this last remaining Blockbuster. First and foremost, you know, the membership card for jumping in. You can get $20 t-shirts, or there's a $20 t-shirt. That's that just literally says last Blockbuster in America. There's just a regular Blockbuster jacket, Blockbuster hat. You can get Blockbuster cups, Blockbuster hoodies, some steel pints.
That's cool.
You can get some Blockbuster magnets for $5. Dude, they're literally going really good as of right now. Wow. And it's crazy because whoever the manager of this store is, whenever this store goes out of business, should get fucking hired on somewhere and get a fat raise because they have the last Blockbuster in the world.
Yeah, if he's able to make that store last for this long.
Yeah.
I mean, imagine what he could do with like a modern store that's actually doing pretty decent.
Yeah, it's a lady.
Oh, is
it? Which kind of makes sense because like I feel like if it was a guy, they probably wouldn't care as much.
You think so?
About the store. Like, I feel like she's putting in like a shit ton of work to like just make it like the best Blockbuster ever, especially as the last one ever.
Yeah. She must really love movies then.
But yeah, it's pretty crazy, wow. Right?
Blockbuster. Yeah, that's hella cool.
We got to go out there to Bend, Oregon.
We got to go to Bend Over, Oregon.
Bend Over, Oregon.
And just sign up.
Yeah, crazy, right?
And all the we should rent a movie and then never pay.
Yeah, $40.
$40, and then we'll start our own streaming service.
In one of their tweets, too, oh my gosh, if I remember correctly, one of their tweets, damn it. Oh, so one of their tweets was, it's basically my favorite one, said, we would still be in business if all the old people didn't die off.
Their clientele just died.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, this is a good one. Sure, the library has cheaper rentals, but we have less homeless men exposing themselves. So, you know, weigh your options. Yeah.
And less homeless men asking for $5.
And this one just says, fuck it. We're a cactus.
That's cool.
Holy shit,
that's good
dude.
To know that there's still a Blockbuster.
I'm going to have to follow this. I'm already following it, of course.
So. I thought they were extinct.
Yeah, yeah. I actually did not even know that there was even two left, let alone right? one.
Wow, that's crazy.
Man. Crazy shit, right?
Hell yeah.
Good old Blockbuster.
Little Blockblister.
Blockblisters.
Well, we're going to take this opportunity to take a commercial break.
Yeah.
And on the other side of the show, the commercial break, we're going to do another tournament for you. So this is the Good Times Podcast, and we'll see you on the other side.
Yeah.
This episode of the Good Times Podcast, we want to give a special shout out to Taste Kitchen. They specialize in Mexican-American street food, some of the best food that you'll have in the Central Valley. Chef and owner Martin Franco has come up with amazing recipes for food that will make you glad you came and make you come back for more. There's tacos, burritos, bowls, asada fries, and new specialty items on the menu all the time. You haven't lived until you've tried their pork belly tacos. Go try them out for yourselves at 6105 East Kings Canyon in the Sunnyside Marketplace Shopping Center. right on the corner of Fowler and Kings Canyon, you know, right next to the GB3. Take a look for yourselves of how good this food looks on their Instagram page at Taste Kitchen. Again, that's Taste Kitchen Mexican American Street Food, located at 6105 East Kings Canyon in the Sunnyside Marketplace Shopping Center. Give them a try and tell them the Good Times Podcast sent you. If you'd like to advertise a product or idea of yours here on the show, shoot us an email to goodtimespodcastgtp@gmail.com. We'd love to work with you and grow both of our brands.
And we're back here on the Good Times Podcast. I hope you enjoyed that commercial. Why? Because I know I did, because I'm the one that did the editing, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know what you're saying.
Sorry, man. You know, sometimes you just get a little riled up about the ghosts and the homeless people and, you know.
Sometimes you find cigarette butts on the floor, you smoke them, and then you end the show, you know.
Smoke them, poke them, do whatever you got to do as long as you get that high. Choke them.
Fuck it.
So I actually wanted to talk about a funny story that happened to me today at work. So I get to work, and one of the things that we have to do is we have to type in, sometimes on this certain form, these people put down, you know, their job and like their description, what it is that they're doing. So this person, this older lady, she calls me over to her desk and she's like, "Hey, I just have a quick question." I'm like, "Yeah, sure. What's up?" And she's like, "Is this correct? Do I just leave it like this?" So what it was is that she was typing in this thing that said part-time office assistant. Okay. But the bar that you're putting it in, uh-huh, it doesn't fit at all. And it literally said part-time office ass.
Yes. That's what I figured it was going to be.
So I looked at it and I started dying, and she's like laughing too. And I'm like, "Yeah, go ahead. You're good." To be completely honest, she is good. She's good to go on that. But it was so funny, dude. Like, good old part-time office ass.
That's just fucking making that cool money. Good old part-time office ass. Can you imagine that's on her like resume? You know, what if it cut off on her resume?
Part-time
office. Her new employer's like, "So I see here that you are a part-time office ass."
Actually, yes. Wait a minute. It's supposed to be assistant.
Under here for your nicknames, it says the One Cheek Wonder.
The One Cheek Wonder. Oh, good old God. One Cheek.
I'm bringing it back.
All right, so what do you got in store for us here today,
well,
Jack?
Let's jump into another tournament here.
Ooh.
This one is going to be the King of Fast Foods.
Oh,
all right. And there's only one rule, really, that's going to separate the fast food places. It has to have a drive-thru.
Oh. Well,
because technically, Subway would count as fast food, but
that's
there's no
true
drive-thru.
That is true. I didn't. Didn't
technically, Chipotle counts as fast food, but there's no drive-thru.
There's no drive-thru.
So all these places have to have a drive-thru. And that's the only really rule of this whole thing.
Damn, okay. Okay, that's pretty all big. Right? That's pretty big.
So we got our eight slots.
Slots?
8 slots.
Including the honorable mentions.
Yeah, well, whatever honorable mentions. As per tradition for the Good Times Podcast, we'll indeed fight for the 8th slot. So I'll let you go first and give the first one.
Okay. The first one, I think it has to be In-N-Out.
In-N-Out.
In-N-Out. That is what a hamburger is all about.
They don't use that slogan. Okay, I'm going to use that. Hang on. I'm going to save that for the thing. Okay. The next one I'll use is Taco Bell.
Taco Bell. Okay. Nice one. Nice one.
The Taco Bell.
Taco. Good old tacos. All right. Next one I got is Wendy's.
Wendy's. All right.
Little Wendy's.
Love me some Wendy's.
Yeah.
Next one I'll go for is more of like a specialty one. El Pollo Loco.
Ooh. El Pollo Loquin. All right. Let's see here. let's see. I said Wendy's. Got to make sure. Oh, Burger King.
Can't oh, about, hell yeah.
Can't forget about the BK.
That's right.
Good old B Kizzle.
I think we'll have to go for. Oh, man. I'm kind of torn a little bit.
Just tearing that asshole.
Just tearing that ass a bit. I'm going to say Carl's Jr.
Oh, I was just looking at that, too. I was like, oh, yeah, we can't forget about this one right here. Oh, man. And that means we got two more slots left. Or technically one. And
we
then,
got technically, we have two. But then one for sure is going to go in.
Yeah, yeah, the fighter ones. Damn. Okay, so you got the Carl's Jr. down. I was actually thinking about that too. Well, I think we have to put in McDonald's.
Okay.
I think they're like the number one like fast food like that really got it going like early on.
Sure.
You know, so
sure.
I think they got to be in there.
Okay, so now we're at the eighth slot. So this is where we'll just throw in some honorables that can fight for the eighth slot.
Yes, indeed.
Jack in the Box.
Jack in the Box, yep, that's true.
Any others?
KFC.
Oh, KFC. Dope. Yep. Almost forgot about them. Popeyes.
Popeyes. Chick-fil-A.
Oh, that's true. They have a drive-thru.
Chick-fil-A.
Chick-fil-A was on the Mandela Effect list.
Oh, that's right. It was like...
Is it spelled C-H-I-C or C-H-I-C? Or, sorry, C-H-I-C-K or
didn't
C-H-I-C.
You didn't really give me much of an option there, you jackass.
Which C is capitalized?
Wait, is it spelled with a K?
No, spelled with a C.
So...
C-H-I-C is the correct one.
Really?
Uh-huh.
On this list that I'm looking at, it says Chick-fil-A with a K.
Huh.
Actually, it is with a K.
Oh, really?
Yeah, this rapper says K on it.
Oh. So, I always thought it was C, but oh well.
Me too.
Oh well. Fuck it. It's chicken.
Chick-N.
The next one I'll throw in is The Habit.
Oh, I forgot that's a fuck. Oh, dude, they're so good. Damn it! I don't want to keep like throwing them in there, but
one more just because it'll be even at six.
Oh my god. So there's two of them I'm looking at. And maybe we'll have to do a fight of a fight of a fight. A fight within a fight within a fight.
Within a fight.
Yeah, so between okay, eighth spot to go into the eighth spot of this eighth spot, I feel like should be between Sonic and Rally's.
Holy shit, how did I forget Rally's? And Rally's was in my head the whole time. Fuck.
So
Sonic, Rally's. All right, fuck it. One more, and it'll be even. One, two, three, geez. Four, five, six, seven. It'll be the eighth slot for eighth. Just whatever we think of next.
I just saw two more. Panda.
I'm gonna disqualify that one.
Okay.
Because not all of them have drive-thrus. Okay. And most new ones do not have drive-thrus.
Okay, that makes sense.
Because they're tag teamed with the Starbucks, and the Starbucks has the drive-thru.
Okay. So I'll make this easier then.
Oh, I got a great one.
Okay.
Panera.
Oh, I forgot about Panera.
Panera.
Okay. Panera.
Okay.
Damn, we got a long-ass honorables mention list.
Yeah, well, because there's so much fast food.
Yeah, so true, so okay. True.
So let's go.
The one I was going to say, though, was Wiener Schnitzel.
Oh, my God.
There's so many. It's ridiculous.
Let's take up Panera, Wiener Schnitzel.
All right, that's cool with me. I was going
to... Weenie Hut.
Weenie Hut General.
Okay, let's go through this honorable mentions first.
All right.
So Jack in the Box versus KFC.
I think I like Jack in the Box more.
Do you go to Jack in the Box more often?
Yes. I haven't been to KFC in like years, to be honest.
Last time I went to KFC was about a month ago, but before that, quite a long time. Yeah. Okay. KFC dead on arrival. About as dead as the chickens that are in there. Rally's and The Habit.
Oh my God. I would have to go with The Habit
Dude, but Rally's fries are bomb.
Rally's fries are bomb, but their burgers are not good.
You don't like a Big Buford?
Dude, it's just so fucking greasy. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, I know there's someone out there. Well, it's supposed to be greasy. That's what makes it taste good.
The grease is the best part of it.
Yeah, exactly. Like, that's not true. But, I mean, at the end of the day, for me personally, I mean, Rally's fries are really good. But so are the Habit fries.
Yeah. And the Habit just came out with his new garlic fries. Ooh. Out of this world. Okay. Rally's is gone.
Gone.
Sorry, Big Buford. Sonic and Chick-fil-A.
Oh, fuck. I don't know, dude.
Dude, you can't deny Chick-fil-A service.
Like, as bar none?
Yeah, dude, they got really good ass service.
Yeah. You know what? Yeah, because the last time I went to Sonic, fuck them. They were like, oh, my God. We waited in line. We ordered, we ordered a bunch of smoothies, and then, so it all came out to like $19, right? And yeah. Then I was like, oh shit, we were supposed to get some apples for, or like some applesauce or like apples or something like that for my niece. And then, so I told the lady, I was like, oh wait, can you add that? She's like, oh yeah, you know what? Don't even worry about it. We'll just throw it in there for you. I was like, all right, cool. So, you know, I have a $20 bill and I gave it to her. And then she's like, actually it's 21 something. And I'm like, what? She's like, yeah, because of the apples. And I'm like, you just said that you're going to get the apples for
free. What the hell?
And I was like, can I just have my $20 back? And then she's like, yeah. And she gave it back, and I just left. I was like, fuck that, dude. So Sonic, fuck you.
Yeah. Dude, you ever notice how dirty it is inside of a Sonic? You know, you don't actually eat in there, but you ever see how dirty the kitchen is?
No. I've never been in
a Gross. Sonic.
Shut up, Grandma.
All right, Sonic dead.
D-E-D.
About as dead as drive-ins are now. And what's the next one? Oh, Wiener Schnitzel and Popeyes. Hot dogs versus chicken.
Well, I don't know. I feel like I like Wiener Schnitzel, and I feel like I like Popeyes too.
Lately, I've been on a Popeyes kick.
Have you?
I found out that they have this thing called Black Ranch. And it's like peppercorn ranch. Oh, it's bomb.
That sounds pretty good.
It is. A fucking chili dog is always good.
I was going to say, like, I feel like Wiener Schnitzel, like, gives you, like, a grimy, like, fucking dog. You know what I mean? Like, the bun's, like, always soggy, but it's still good as fuck. Like, just because it's been, like, soaking in chili the whole time.
I mean, there's no real good way to present a fast food hot dog.
Oh, no, not at all. Like, I'll get one from, like, you know, like Sonic or something like that.
Okay.
Like,
there's nothing bad either. I want to know if I'm the only one that does this, but when you get a Wiener Schnitzel hot dog and you unwrap it, you know, a chili dog,
uh-huh.
Do you lick the paper because there's chili left on it?
Honestly, I don't remember if I've done that because I haven't done it in a long time, but I will say yes, probably.
The chili's fucking good.
Yeah, it really
is. It's good.
It is really good.
So, do you want to go Popeyes or Wiener Schnitzel?
Damn, some people can get so pissed off, but I would go Wiener Schnitzel, to be honest. I mean, yeah, Wiener Schnitzel.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
All right, Jack in the Box or Chick-fil-A?
Fuck.
Jack in the Box is open late, and it's open on Sundays.
24-hour jack-in-the-boxes.
Chick-fil-A is closed on Sundays, has amazing service, but the Chick-fil-A sauce is fucking bomb.
Oh, my God.
It's so good.
I don't know. Like, I'm not a big fan of jack-in-the-boxes burgers. Their tacos, I love their fucking tacos so damn.
They're a hamburger joint, but you go there for the tacos?
Dude, their tacos are fucking good. Maybe because I just
have. I've never had their tacos.
Oh, I've had them so many times, like when I'm drunk, or even just regularly. Like,
well, what are they? Like a dollar?
They're like $1.29 now, or something like that. Yeah, they raised the price. It was
just 50, like the bumps did.
It was it was 50 cents at one point.
50 cents for one taco?
One taco.
Damn.
Yeah, dude.
What the fuck's in there?
It's half beef, half tofu.
Half dog food.
This is tough.
I'm kind of leaning more towards Jack in the Box. Mostly for the reason that Janet and I have gone to a Chick-fil-A on multiple Sundays and they've been closed.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh, man.
Because whoever owns it, you know, the owner is like a super Christian or whatever. So yeah, he's, you know, yeah, like, but we're closed on Sundays.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm leaning Jack in the Box.
I can respect it. So, yeah, Jack in the Box is fine.
All right. Chick-fil-A is dead. Habit or Wiener Schnitzel?
Habit.
Yeah, we'll go Habit. That was quick.
Yeah.
Later, weenies. And then Jack in the Box and Habit.
Habit. Yeah, I gotta go with Habit on that one, okay, man.
That was quick.
Now I want Habit now.
Oh, I know, dude. They're so good.
It's so good.
Okay. So here we go for the main tournament here. That was a tournament inside of a tournament.
Yeah, that was pretty fun. Okay.
First round, we have In-N-Out versus The Burger King.
Oh, my God.
Second round, we have Taco Bell versus Carl's Jr. Next round, we have Wendy's versus McDonald's. And then in the last round, we have El Pollo Loco versus the winner of the undercard tournament, The Habit.
Damn. So just to go over that again, we got In-N-Out versus BK. Then we got Taco Bell versus Carl's Jr.
Yep.
And then Wendy's versus McDonald's.
Yep.
And then The Habit versus the Crazy Chicken.
Yep. Versus Poco Loco.
El Pollo Loco.
That's right.
All right.
Okay. First round, In-N-Out and BK. Who do you want? More like, fuck it. You know, we're not even going to take sides. We'll just fucking debate this thing outright. Because, I mean, everybody. Both of you and I have eaten there many times and everybody else has too. So we don't even really need to take sides.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm leaning more towards In-N-Out personally.
For what reason though?
The quality. Oh, the quality.
Say, well, I wouldn't choose In-N-Out for the people that work there.
Oh, damn, that's so bad.
I'll be honest. I hate fucking In-N-Out French fries.
Really?
Dude, those are the shittiest cardboard French fries ever. Really? The only way I eat those now is either animal style or I have Dog to get style. The sauce, the spread. I'll ask them for a packet of spread and I have to put those on there. I can't eat it with ketchup.
Huh.
Burger King fries I can have just plain or with ketchup.
Burger King fries are pretty good. The only thing I don't like about Burger King fries is that when they like start getting like a little bit lukewarm, like they start losing their warmth, they just turn into fucking cardboard.
Well, I guess both places have cardboard fries.
Well, I guess it's not straight up cardboard, but just like, you know, cold potatoes don't taste very good. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Double double versus a Whopper. I love me a Whopper.
I love me a double double, man.
Ooh. Okay, what's the separation? Is it the special sauce? Is it charbroiled versus fried? Or no, excuse me, they're flame broiled.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, Carl's Jr. is charbroiled.
I just think if anything would be quality, right? I mean, they would In-N-Out gets basically everything, you know, fresh and whatnot.
Yeah,
nothing's like frozen. I'm pretty sure BK doesn't freeze shit anymore.
Yeah, probably not anymore, but I don't think In-N-Out ever did they?
No, not at probably all. Probably not. There's no way.
Okay, I'll give this to In-N-Out, though. Every time they give you, you know, your shit in a box, you know, they'll just give it to you in the box so you take it home or whatever, or the eat it in the car or whatever. It always looks pretty.
Yeah.
The fries are there.
So fucking good. Like,
fries are there, the hamburger's there, and then, you know, you get your drink or your shake.
Yeah. Oh, and fucking, the shakes. Oh, I forgot about that.
And Burger King just, you know, gives you your shit and, you know, you open it up and there's fucking lettuce sprinkled everywhere.
In your fucking bag.
Yeah.
I think In-N-Out just keeps it really simple what you can order. Like, I do like having options, like all the options that BK has. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, simplicity can definitely be like, you know, a very high form of, tasting really good.
That's true. You know, you go to In-N-Out for a burger because,
right,
you know, and that's what they have. Burgers, and that's
burgers.
It. You know, you go to Burger King shape, and there's, you know, the 1 through 5 is hamburgers, but then, you know, fucking 6 through 10 are chicken sandwiches, and then, you know, 11 through fucking 15 are miscellaneous shit.
Yeah, no, I agree. I agree.
Nuggets, like chicken fries, fucking chicken fries salads, and so all that bullshit. Yeah,
so disappointing. Chicken fries.
However, man. Burger King has the $1.50 nuggets. They're bomb, dude.
I thought they were just, oh, it was like $1.50 for like 50 or some shit.
For 50? Yeah, right. That'd be the deal of the century. It's $1.50 for 10.
Oh, okay, okay.
Well, those are really good.
They had like 10 for 50 cents or something like that.
The fuck?
I don't know. Somebody.
The hell are those made out of? Chicken ass.
Yeah, I don't really mind Burger King nuggets, but they're not like a, if I were to not eat them, then yeah, it's not a really big deal.
Yeah.
It would be hard to go without In-N-Out.
Burger King's never really busy, though, compared to In-N-Out.
That's true. Maybe because it sucks. No, but if I ever go to BK, I usually get like a fucking fat ass bacon burger, if anything.
Yeah.
But that's really like, that's really,
oh, In-N-Out doesn't have bacon, huh?
No, they don't have bacon now.
Oh, man.
They just have their grilled onions and all that other and good their shit.
Special skeet sauce. Man, well, as much as I wanted Burger King to win, I'll put In-N-Out over.
Okay. In-N-Out goes over.
Damn.
So this next one, we got Taco Bell.
Tacos.
Versus Charles Jr.
Ooh. Tacos versus burgers.
Yes.
But see, Carl's Jr., though, here's the thing, though, is they got chicken sandwiches and salads and tenders and all that bullshit, too.
They do.
Taco Bell's menu is fucking huge, though, too.
Taco Bell's menu is fucking huge.
Tacos, gorditas, chalupas, fucking nachos. They got burritos. They got fucking everything.
Yeah.
Mexican pizzas? I don't even know what the fuck that is.
Have you ever had a Mexican pizza?
No.
It's really good. It's actually really
good. I don't even know what the fuck it is.
It's not filling, but it's really good.
But it's cheap. Dude, that's the thing with Taco Bell. You can go there late night, spend about $10, and you get a bag full of good shit.
You would get a bag full of good shit. If you were to go to Carl's Jr., though, and spend $10, you would get some pretty good shit. Like, it would be less.
You'd have to get the small, but it'd be some good shit.
Yeah, yeah. Like, whenever I usually go, it's to get, like, a double Western. Like, double Westerns are so fucking good.
I either get a double Western or I get a Big Carl.
Oh,
because if Carl's, I just want burger with the, you know, like no veggies to deal with, I'll get the Big Carl. That's okay. All you get. You get the two patties, you get the lettuce, the ketchup, and all the other bullshit they put on it.
What did you get?
Huh?
Two what?
Two patties.
Fuck you, Patty.
Fuck you, fuck you, Patty.
Well, I don't, like, okay, so just jumping back into Taco Bell then, like,
sure.
Whenever I go into Taco Bell, I always get chalupas. And I fucking love chalupas. And I love a lot of shit on their list. But honestly, this is a deal breaker for me. There's some shit that they give out that is still fucking cold constantly. Like, whenever I get like chalupas, they're always cold.
Really?
They're always fucking cold. It's like they're lukewarm on the outside, but in the middle, it's always fucking cold. And I'm not just talking about one Taco Bell. I'm talking about multiple places where it's always fucking cold.
Huh.
And I've had a few other like things on the menu that came out cold. Like, dude, I had the fucking potato griller. The first time I ever had a potato griller, like 3 years ago when they first came out, it was like the most amazing thing I've ever had. I had one the other day. Trash. The fucking potato tasted like ass. Fucking rubber.
Oh, God.
It, like, gave you that rubbery taste. I don't remember what it was, dude, but, like,
damn.
I don't know. It's kind of like a deal breaker for me on the cold thing. It just comes out cold. I don't know why.
Well, I got
cold.
Another log to throw on there.
Another log?
Yeah.
Putting in your log.
Whenever I get that $5 box of whatever it is at the time, you know, it could be a chalupa or a naked taco, you know, whatever the fuck.
Like the other night.
Yeah. I don't like those fucking churro twisty thingies.
Oh, no.
The cinnamon gets everywhere. It makes your hands all sticky and shit. And it's just That's a pain true. In the ass.
That's true.
You're going to end up with a dirty fucking car because of how much cinnamon is just coming off of that shit.
You might find cinnamon on the floor from the ones I ate the other day.
Probably. Yeah, because I gave you mine, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, you're like, no, I don't want those. I was like, okay, yeah, cool.
Well, see, look, there's the proof right there. Yeah.
It's probably all over my guard, too. Fucking shit.
See, there you go. Well, if you vacuum it, you'll be all right.
Yeah. Honestly, if you're looking for, like, quantity over quality, it's easily Taco Bell. But yeah, if we're talking about, like, if you're looking for a really good burger that's, like, really messy, some pretty good fries, and, like, a fat fucking drink, you know, like, I feel like it's just Carl's Jr. It's
yeah. Well, I remember Carl's Jr. was always, like, targeted as, like, this is the man's fucking fast food restaurant. That's you know, true, all the commercials, they have all the, like, half-naked chicks eating hamburgers.
And, I forgot about that.
You know, they'd always be like, what was it, the slogan? Don't bother me. I'm eating. That was fucking dope.
I remember that, too.
Yeah. So, as a man, I'm going to vote for Carl's Jr.
As a man? Oh, man. Now there's going to be a bunch of feminists out there that are going to be so mad. I'm never going to Carl's Jr. again.
Fuck it. They probably don't want it anyway.
Oh my god,
they can't decide where they want to go anyway. So yeah, so my vote's for Carl's Jr.
So this next one's a pretty tough one as well.
Wait, you didn't even vote?
Yeah, I said Carl's Jr.
Oh, all right, fuck you, Taco Bell.
Yeah, sorry, I thought I was clear about that. Oh. I guess not.
Yeah,
fuck you, Taco Bell. Am I clear enough?
Yeah, the next one's a good heavyweight fight.
Yeah, this is a good heavyweight.
This one, we have Wendy's versus McDonald's.
McDonald's.
Here we go.
So, I am super biased here. And I know I'm the one that put in McDonald's, but I put in McDonald's because, well, you know, they just have to be in there. I feel like they're like a Coca-Cola almost, you know, have sure. to be in there.
Yeah.
But I'm super biased because McDonald's chicken nuggets are the ones that put me in the hospital twice.
I'm gonna add something here. But how many times did you go to every other place on this list before you had those chicken nuggets?
A lot. But okay. But I had those nuggets that one day, okay? And then I went to the hospital, and then a week later, I was like, maybe it wasn't McDonald's. So I had chicken nuggets again, went to the hospital.
And that's the time you called me, right?
And that was the time I called you. Hey, man, what are you doing? I was about to get it on in 15 minutes.
Pretty much.
I was like, could you take me to the hospital? Like, yeah.
I'm just, like, oh, fuck, all right.
I was, like, trying to be, like, as, like,
nonchalant.
Yeah, because I'd be like, hey, man, can you take me to the hospital? My heart's going crazy again.
You just start, You're like, all right, yeah, let me put my dick away. I got a problem with both of these.
Okay.
Now, the wait time is ridiculous.
Oh my god, Wendy's okay. Wait times, dude.
Wait time for Wendy's has always kind of been a little long because I don't know why. Last time I went to Wendy's, I ordered basic shit, dude. This is their $5 bag. You know, it's crispy chicken sandwich. You know, a little hamburger and fries, and I think like a cookie and a drink.
Yeah, yeah.
I was in that line for like 20 minutes, bro.
Damn, dude.
I would have left if I didn't already paid. Okay, and now McDonald's, every time you go get a quarter pounder with cheese, they park you.
Really?
It's happened every single time. And almost every single time that I've gotten breakfast in the morning when breakfast is served, they park me. We're like, yeah, can I get 2 McGriddles with cheese? Okay, I go pay. I get to the window. Oh, here's your orange juice. Would you mind parking in slot number 2? And we'll bring it out to you. It's breakfast time. Be ready for that shit. Am I right?
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
It's lunchtime. I want a quarter pounder with cheese. Be ready for that shit. What the fuck?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I haven't really had much problem in terms of McDonald's wait times. I've definitely had problems with Wendy's wait times. That gets you all the time. I think one thing over Wendy's, I mean, so the one of the things I really like about Wendy's, obviously, their burgers. They just have some really good burgers. Like, I can't really, like, name anything. Like, you know, the Junior Bacon Cheeseburger is really good.
The only sandwich I know is called, like, the Famous Dave or Dave's Famous Burger or whatever.
Dave's Famous Anus?
Yeah, but other than that, I couldn't tell you the name of a Wendy's hamburger.
That's true.
My dad calls them kangaroo burgers. Because they're square.
Oh.
You know, and apparently they're square because Wendy's doesn't cut corners.
Oh, my God. That's pretty funny. I just remember seeing, like, triple, quadruple, quintuplet burgers. They just keep adding shit on there.
Yeah, I remember that.
Dude,
That's during the time when, like, every fast food place was like, we're just going to add more meat. And then, like, we're going to give you a 44-ounce soda.
And if
it's going to fatten you up.
And if you eat this quadruple burger, you will get a t-shirt that says, raise the stakes.
That says, I'm going to die. For real, dude, they had that. They had, like, you know, McDonald's had their super size.
Uh-huh.
Burger King had their king size. Wendy's has just always had big shit.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, Carl's Jr.'s always had big shit.
Yeah, that's true.
Their large is ridiculous.
Their large is large.
Man. We'll save them for the next round.
yeah, for sure. But I don't know. Like, I like Wendy's, but I think the thing that separates McDonald's from Wendy's is their breakfast.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
I've always been a huge fan of their breakfast, especially their fucking hash brown patty fire.
Ooh.
Right here.
Yeah. And Wendy's, I don't think, has ever done breakfast.
That's true.
If they have, they're not doing a good job.
Yeah. And they're like, we have a whole breakfast menu.
Really?
Really?
Where?
Yeah, it's only we only serve breakfast between the times of 6 and 6:30 a.m.
That probably is Wendy's. That is a Wendy's thing.
Yeah, and like they only serve one person because that person's in line for 30 fucking minutes.
Yep, that's a Wendy's thing.
Yeah, fuck you, Wendy's, you're out.
All right, McDonald's wins.
Even though I don't eat them as much anymore.
All right, next one.
All right, we got The Habit. So this is the final first round one. We have The Habit versus the Crazy Chicken, El Pollo Loco.
Now, I'll tell you this. I didn't really start going to The Habit until they built one by my house. But I've always seemed to have gone to El Pollo Loco.
Oh.
And the closest El Pollo Loco from me is about 3 miles.
Okay.
So that kind of tells you how good El Pollo Loco is to me.
So, I like El Pollo Loco as well. Now, okay, so here's a difference between they're going inside and fast food. I feel like when you're doing like when you're going through the drive-thru, you're like, can I get a burrito or can I get a bowl? But if you're going inside, I feel like it's always, can I get the fucking ginormous platter of chicken? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, unless it's just me.
I mean, I never get the ginormous platter of chicken.
Well, I mean, we need to feed a family. I mean,
oh yeah, I guess
the chicken, and then they're
well, it's the same thing with KFC. I mean, when you go through, you're just like, hey, I'm getting one bucket, you know. And then they get the 10-piece bucket. But when you go inside, let me get the 50-piece. Give me all the chicken you got.
4 buckets, please.
For real.
And then I do have to say that El Pollo Loco's mac and cheese is fucking good, too.
Dude.
Mac and cheese.
Yeah, I agree with that. But they had these things called Loco Street Tacos. They don't have them anymore, which I really hope that they bring them back. And they're... They're, you know, street taco size, so it's like the little tortillas.
Okay.
And it's like shredded chicken with like a chipotle sauce and like pico de gallo on it.
Ooh.
Oh my God, dude. It was so good. And they were only $1.25 a piece.
Wow.
Yeah, they were really good.
That sounds really good.
Yeah, but now what I get there is either the original pollo bowl, which is basically like rice, beans.
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 the chicken, and then onion, pico de gallo, and cilantro. And that's it. And okay. It's for only for $5, and you get chips and a drink with it.
Ooh.
And then the other thing I get is the double chicken bowl, which is basically all of that except times two.
Not bad.
Yeah.
Not bad.
And it's fairly healthy, you know.
Yeah.
If once you minus out the Spanish rice.
Yeah. Well, I've always liked to have it because I always felt like they were pretty quick in terms of their drive-thru and stuff like that. When I used to work at this this place right next to a Habit, literally walking distance from a Habit, I would get like a 15-minute break, and I would literally just walk over there, get a burger, walk back, and I would still have like 5 minutes. Like,
wow.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy.
And you like, eat that thing in 5 minutes?
No. Oh. So I took longer than 15 minutes.
But, yeah, okay.
But I mean, it was kind of crazy. Like, you know, you walk over there, you get it, and walk back. But I don't know what it is about the Habit fries. Like, first and foremost, you know, a big thing about McDonald's is obviously their fries, and we'll get to that a little bit later. You know, they have like
The Habit wins.
Yeah, and they have, you know, a really, you know, gold look. And so does the Habit. Like, the Habit's fries has like this gold look. And dude, I don't know what it is about those damn fries, but they are just fucking good.
Yeah. And now, like I told you, that they have those garlic ones.
Oh, yeah.
The garlic lordy.
Oh, lordy.
Pollo Loco, though, man, is grilled chicken, and that shit's good. You could taste the seasonings on it. Oh, gato.
It's good. Shit, food.
It's good,
food. Oh, shit, vato. Yeah, I like a Pollo Loco as well. Once again, the Habit for me.
The hell? Damn robot.
Damn robots. The Habit for me, I really like their burgers as well. I always felt like their menu was pretty damn simple. It was like, do you want cheese? Do you want bacon? You know, do you want this or that? It was all, you know, always really simple. That's always one of the things I liked about the Habit, is that a lot of it's really simple.
Yeah.
Pollo Loco is really good.
Pollo Loco is pretty simple too. But I think the deciding factor in this is that if you want to like have like, you know, like a fairly healthy, fairly clean kind of lunch, you know, on your lunch break, mm-hmm. you'd go to a Pollo Loco.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Cuz you can get a chicken bowl for $5 and it's, you know, fairly clean. You can get yourself a tea after that and there you go, you're good.
Right, right.
But I mean, any other day that you're not trying to be healthy, you're probably going to get a burger.
Yep.
And if there's a Habit there, you know you're going to get a really good hamburger. Mm. You know you're going to get really good fries.
You're going to go to the Habitual.
They have, you know, sodas and shakes. And the shake, the strawberry shake tastes just like Nesquik.
Oh, really? It's, I haven't had that before.
Amazing. Janet's got it tons of times, and it's really, really good. Damn, I need to get it. And, yeah. So, and you know you're going to get it for a fairly decent price, considering some hamburger places are enormously high.
Yeah.
Like Wendy's.
So is their wait time.
Yeah, so I'm leaning towards the Habit.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Unless you could change my mind.
The one of the bigger deciding factors in terms of a Pollo Loco, because I'm leaning towards the Habit as well, but the one of the bigger deciding factors is
what?
through all of these fast food places that we've talked about, we've never mentioned beans, we've never mentioned mashed potatoes. Or we've never mentioned macaroni and cheese.
Well, the thing with mashed potatoes is that KFC didn't get into the thing.
Oh, that's true, too.
And neither did Popeyes.
Oh, yeah,
true, But, yeah, I kind of agree with that, because considering everything on this list is basically hamburgers.
Yeah. Maybe we can get a little chicken alternate in there.
Yeah.
I don't know. Honestly, I was leaning towards the Habit the whole time. But I think that's kind of like a thing for me, is like,
diversity.
And
but like I said, yeah, I've been kind of going to Pollo Loco for longer, so yeah, maybe my mind has changed. Maybe I will go Pollo Loco.
All right,
Pollo Loco.
Man, that was a pretty crazy fight right there.
Yeah, the Habit won for nothing.
Heavyweight. Yeah, I know. I was Habit all the way, but then I was like, yeah, you know, you got some pretty good points about the Pollo Loco, man.
Yeah. All right, so we're moving on to the second round, and we have In-N-Out versus Carl's Jr.
Damn.
Winner goes to the finals.
Winner goes to the finals.
Fuck. Both of them have a secret sauce.
Yes, they do.
On their burger. One's charbroiled? Yeah, charbroiled, and the other one is fried.
Okay.
In-N-Out's fries have regular and animal style.
Okay.
Carl's Jr.'s fries have regular. They have the crisp cut ones, which are seasoned.
Ooh, I forgot about those.
And they also have onion rings.
Oh
onion, onion rings.
Onion.
Yeah. But then after that, if we're just going to narrow it down to that, because Carl Jr. has a lot of other shit.
Okay.
They got salads. They got chicken sandwiches that ain't that good because I've gotten one and it ain't that good.
Ain't that good.
So we'll just go to basics because burger, fries, and fry variations.
I don't know if you can just go basics though because I've had their, they actually had this really heavy fucking burger. I don't know if you've ever had it. They're, Carl's Jr.
Heavy burger?
They've had a really heavy burger. It was not, that wasn't the name of it. It was just, It's just a heavy burger. It was their breakfast burger.
Oh, God. This goes back to, was it last week where you're going to wake up and start your day off with a hamburger?
Dude, I had it one time in the morning. Yeah, I'll never do it again because it was so fun. Now, don't get me wrong. It was fucking good.
Okay.
It was one of the better burgers, like one of the better breakfast burgers I've had. But it was fucking heavy, man. They have a lot of shit, though. They have a lot of shit. Like,
you want to talk about a heavy burger, though. In-N-Out has the 4x4.
Oh, my God.
Four patties, four pieces of cheese.
Fuck you, Patty.
And all the other shit that they throw on their hamburger.
Yeah, true that.
That's a lot of shit.
That's a lot of shit.
That's going to make you take a big shit.
Yeah, that's true. And their cheese really fucking good, too. I've always, I don't like their cheese on fries because it just makes it look weird. But yeah, I don't know.
I'm not so picky on cheese. I think everybody uses the same cheese.
It just looks like film. Like, I don't know what it is. Like,
they're all Kraft singles.
But that's what I'm saying. It just looks like film on a fucking on fries and it's like
cheese.
Yeah,
that's all it is. It's not even cheese. It's the cheese substitute or cheese product or whatever the fuck.
Cheese prostitute.
It's all vegetable oil. That's all it is.
Yeah, yeah.
You get a bigger burger with Carl's Jr., though.
Ooh.
You get a really big burger with Carl's Jr. Who the fuck is messaging me on my phone? Oh, fucking James. Mr. Long Leg Daddy-O. Anyway, he's not here. He can't debate this. Get out of here. But yeah, you get a really big hamburger with Carl's Jr. compared to basically the same size hamburger.
Yeah, true.
Carl's Jr. has a kid's meal.
Yeah, they do.
They got chicken nuggets shaped in the stars.
Yeah, In-N-Out just gets number one for kids. Number one.
Yeah, it's basically like 1, 2, and 3 for them, right?
Yeah.
It goes double cheeseburger and then just hamburger, right?
Now, they both have a secret sauce, but does Carl's Jr. have a secret menu?
Nah, they just throw everything at you at once.
So I've always been intrigued by the In-N-Out secret menu. One of them being what you mentioned earlier, the 4x4, because that's definitely not on the menu.
Do you have a list in front of you what's on the secret menu?
No, but I can pull it up.
Because all I know that's on the secret menu, what the hell is that?
It's the
dryer,
yeah.
God, it's shaking the whole house. The secret menu, all I know that's on there is the 4x4 and the animal fries. I don't know if there's anything else.
Okay.
It's not even a secret anymore.
Yeah. Well, one of them that's on there that I always remember just because of the name was the Flying Dutchman.
What's that?
It's literally two patties with cheese melted between them, and that's it. Huh. There's no bun. There's nothing. It's just literally two patties with cheese.
Can you go through? That's probably why they named it the Flying Dutchman. They're tired of people just going like, can I just get meat and cheese?
Can I get the Flying Dutchman? So the other ones are protein style.
Carl's Jr. does that. I've gotten it from them.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Carl's Jr. actually has a turkey burger.
Oh, not I didn't bad. Know that. Not bad.
What else?
Grilled cheese.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody could do that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's just something people don't know what to ask for. Neapolitan shake.
Okay.
Mustard grilled patty burger. What the fuck?
They probably just throw mustard on the grill with the patty.
Yeah, that makes sense. Cheese fries.
Yeah.
Well done fries.
That's the same thing.
4x4. Whole grilled onion burger, where they just basically just cook it with a fucking whole grilled onion on it.
Yeah. For the people that like bad breath.
You can get root beer float.
Oh, come on. That shouldn't be on the secret menu. You could do that yourself. Hey, can I get a cup of ice cream? And then just go over to the fountain and pour out some root beer.
animal style burger, which actually, you know, I didn't even think about. That is a secret menu thing because it's not actually on the menu.
Yeah. Well, none of this stuff is really.
Yeah. 3x3 animal style fries. Oh, and then adding peppers. A lot of people don't know about that.
Oh, I didn't know they had peppers.
What? They had the little ghost peppers.
No, I didn't know they had those.
They're so good, dude.
Well, I guess they did keep a secret from me.
Yeah. Next time you go in, just ask them to chop it up, throw it in there. Or like, just, yeah. Or you could just request them and they'll give it. It's like a little baggie, like a clear baggie. And there's literally two peppers in there that are uncut. Oh, cool. Yeah.
Here's this. In-N-Out's only on the West Coast.
Oh.
Carl's Jr. is nationwide. Even though they have to change their name on the East Coast to Hardee's. But it's the same star.
Yeah.
It's the same shit.
So
I don't know if that accounts for anything.
I mean, it's kind of crazy because, like, when you think about it, it's like it's only on the West Coast. I mean, they are finally moving out, like, to different places. Like, I know the furthest one out, I think, is Texas.
Oh, I was going to say Arizona, but if there's one in Texas, I believe that.
There's a few in Texas, yeah.
We'll narrow it down to this. We both like wrestling. Whenever wrestlers come to the West Coast, they always post pictures of In-N-Out.
That's true. That's true.
Yep.
But, whenever you get your ticket stub on the back of it, you always get a free famous star. Right.
That's true. That is so true. And you always get their flyers in the mail.
True. However, I will say that I've never used that ticket to ever get a free famous star.
You haven't?
No.
I have.
I've gotten like so many tickets and I always forget to use them.
Dude, I have.
I mean, it makes sense because you're super frugal and I'm just compulsive when I come to spend.
Well, here's the thing though too, is that a lot of Carl's Juniors are tag teamed with the Green Burrito.
Oh yeah.
I've used the flyers in the mail for the Green Burrito one time.
I think I've had Green Burrito like once.
I'm not even shitting you, dude. They had a deal where it's like, oh, if you buy a famous star with cheese or whatever like that, they'll give you like a free like breakfast burrito or something like that. Mm. And it was good. It was really good. That's the secret menu good. Right there, the Green Burrito.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Which way do you want to go on this one? It's kind of a toss-up, really.
Fuck, dude.
Man.
I don't know.
Yeah. I got a quarter.
Flip
a coin, I guess.
Yeah, we could do that.
Okay.
That's what we got.
Heads, In-N-Out, tails, Carl's Jr.
All right,
here we go.
It landed sideways.
Tails.
Oh.
Tails.
In-N-Out gets destroyed by the quarter itself.
By the coin flip. Wow.
Damn. That was dude.
That's
honestly
one of those things where like you see the boxers punching each other at the same time.
Yeah.
And then one just happens to connect right before. That's what that was right there.
That's true. You're absolutely right. And honestly, I'm glad we had a quarter because I would not be able to pick. Like,
I know, me either.
Dude, that was tough.
Yeah. David's pulling his hair out right now. No, he's not. He's not. He doesn't even listen to the show.
Oh, yeah. And he doesn't work there.
He either. Lies that he listens to the show. That's right, David. I'm calling you out.
Yeah, David. Bastard.
All right. Next one.
So the next one, and the final one, to meet the winner of this, will meet Carl's Jr. in the finals. We got McDonald's versus the Crazy Chicken.
Poco Loco.
Poco Loco.
El Pollo Loyal. Pollo Loyal.
Pollo Loyal. Oh my How God. Loyal is it?
It's pretty loyal. El Pollo Loco was mentioned in Rush Hour 2.
Oh.
But McDonald's is, like, mentioned everywhere.
Yeah, I was going to say, McDonald's been in, like, every fucking movie.
Yeah, it's everywhere. Pusha T was the guy who wrote the ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I just got diabetes.
And then Justin Timberlake was the guy who sang it.
Oh, really?
It's a pretty good tag team right there.
I mean, in terms of popularity, it's obvious that McDonald's is, you know, one of the number one fast food restaurants.
Yeah, because America hates Mexicans and they hate Pollo Loco.
Oh my God. I mean, at the end of the day, I wouldn't say at the end of the day because it's not the end of the discussion, but
yeah.
I just say that just to fill words.
Yeah, because your mentor used to say it all the time.
He did?
Yes, he would say it all the time. Him and his brother.
Really?
Yeah. Go to the club next time and you'll hear it.
Damn it. Now I'm going to have to fucking... Damn it!
Yeah. Anytime that he's talking to the group, you'll hear it.
At the end of the day.
Like, come on, guys. You know, because, you know, at the end of the day, you know, we got to do what we got to do. And, yeah.
I don't remember that. But
yeah. Next time. I don't know. Next time, just take a listen. All right. or watch an old video.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Anyway, back to the real shit.
All right. So we've talked about McDonald's breakfast. Does El Pollo Loco have any type of breakfast?
You know, I don't know.
That's a good idea. Look that up real quick. I mean,
if
we had to look it up, then, yeah, you know, I still have to look.
But McDonald's chicken cannot compare with Pollo Loco's chicken.
No, they cannot. No,
they cannot compete with that chicken. Are you looking up a breakfast menu?
Yeah.
So you got pretty quiet.
And I was also biting one of my nails. Oh,
so you got. Does that nail taste like Pollo Loco?
Nope. Tastes like ass. I scratched my ass earlier.
No. You should get pink eye, bro.
Oh, man. I'd rather get stink eye.
Stink eye?
Yeah, dude. They don't have, like, breakfast, and they've never had breakfast.
What time do they open?
Ooh,
they probably open it by, like, 10 or 11 then, huh?
Shit. Let's see what time
McDonald's has all-day breakfast now, but they used to stop at, I think, 10:30.
Ooh, 10:30.
So, I mean, that's probably what time Pollo Loco would have opened then.
Well, let's see. This one says 10 a.m. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. 10 see, that start opens times. After breakfast.
Yeah. Okay, so that makes complete sense. And they close at 11, which is not a bad time either. You know, because, I mean, no one's at like 3 in the morning going, oh, man. I just really want some Pollo Loco right now.
I could really go for a Pollo bowl.
Yeah. I really wanted a Pollo fucking chicken burrito right now.
Yeah.
Although I could see somebody saying, oh, man, I really want some son of a bitch.
Hey, up out there.
Shut the fuck up. No.
We need one of those little red lights that blinks instead of recording.
You know what? My sister said to get one.
Like she would even follow it. She's loud even when she's downstairs. What are you talking about?
It's true. Yeah. But yeah, I could see somebody saying like, I want a El Pollo Loco mac and cheese. Like,
yeah. Yeah, or some tacos or something.
Yeah, but I mean, if they want tacos, they can just go to like one of those taco places down the street.
One of the trucks, yeah.
Yeah.
Boy. McDonald's has a kids menu. Pollo Loco doesn't.
Ooh, they don't, huh?
No. You get a free toy. It's usually something pretty stupid.
Oh, my God. McDonald's?
Pollo Loco doesn't have a mascot.
They don't. It's just a chicken.
Yeah, they had the guy that sounded like Zorro for a little bit on the commercials.
They did?
Yeah.
I don't remember any fucking...
El Pollo Loco, the flame grilled that you can taste.
That's right.
You know, they had that guy. And then they had the commercial, El Pollo Loco.
El Pollo Loco.
That's about it. But I mean, McDonald's has how many mascots? Fucking...
Oh my God.
Ronald, Hamburglar, Grimace, Fry Guys.
Grumpus.
That one chicken-looking bitch. That's just five off the top of my head.
That's true. And also, McDonald's has a lot of different varieties in different countries.
Yep. I know they have different meats for wherever they're at.
Yeah. So, and they always have like a different burger or something like that. You know what's funny is that sometimes different franchises have different prices.
That's now, true.
I don't know if this has changed over the past few years, but I know when I was younger... there was a McDonald's in Madeira, I believe. Yeah, it was in Madeira. And they would have, what was it? Big Macs for $1.
What?
Yeah.
Where was I?
I know. And, one of my friends, his stepdad would always blame McDonald's for getting fat because, dude, every day he would always go to McDonald's and just get a fucking Big Mac for $1.
I'll tell you this though, dude. I'll take a Pollo Bowl over a Big Mac because you get like that much meat and like this much bread.
Yeah, yeah.
There's no comparison for
but
that.
But at the end of the day, like it wouldn't be between a bowl and a Big Mac. It, like for me, it's like I'm getting either like I'm getting a quarter pounder or I'm getting a double cheeseburger.
That's true.
Because I
you're either going really expensive or really cheap.
Yeah, because Big Macs are cool, but and they have the special sauce and everything gives them a good flavor, but all that bread is not needed.
Yeah, that's true.
And I don't know, man, something about being drunk and wanting to get a fucking double cheeseburger just the other night, remember?
Yeah, but we couldn't order anything because they wouldn't take a card.
And that's another thing. That is another thing. After like 2 or 3 o'clock, they go to cash only for like an hour.
Yeah, dude, and that shit happens all the time.
And it happens all the time. Oh, here's the thing.
Their fucking ice cream machine's always broke.
Oh! Oh no!
How hard is it to get a GD ice cream cone at, you know, 11 o'clock at night?
Oh my
God. It could be 11 o'clock at night. It could be 10 in the morning. It could be 1:30 in the afternoon. It could be 5:30 in the afternoon, in the evening, whatever the fuck. It's broken.
it's always
broken.
Fucking broken.
Janet used to work at McDonald's and she said that it wasn't broken. It's just that's when it was cleaning itself.
So they're cleaning itself like a dog.
Yeah, it's licking its ass. No, she said, yeah, that's when it would be cleaning. Like it has like a self-cleaning thing or something, you know, like to sanitize itself or whatever.
Uh-huh.
So they're already lying to you.
Oh,
it's not broken.
Gosh.
It's just
down, you know,
for cleaning, for maintenance. They're lying.
Liars.
A Pollo Loco doesn't lie. Chicken, beans, rice, cilantro, and onions and cheese. They don't lie. McDonald's does.
You know what's funny is that I actually have a friend that works at McDonald's right now, and I remember I was on her face. I saw a Facebook post that she put up, and she was like mad at everybody who like talked shit about the ice cream machine.
She's gonna hate us.
Yeah, she's all, you know what? If you guys are really talking shit about the ice cream machine, you know, then blah, 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 this and that. You guys should work there. You guys will really understand what it's like and da da da. I'm like, damn, like Frosted Flakes, damn.
I do understand what it really feels like because Janet was a manager at a McDonald's for a little while.
True that.
So I know, even without being there.
I know. Dude, oh man, that is like, that is a heartbreaker right there.
It is.
So many times I'm like, oh yeah, let's get a dollar cone. They're a dollar, one fucking dollar, four quarters. And 10 dimes, whatever the fuck.
It's like playing the lottery. Some days you're lucky and you can get your cone. Yep. But then most days, you ain't getting shit.
Damn. And then especially after 3 o'clock where it's cash only. Like, yep. Where the fuck am I going to go get cash just to go to McDonald's? Bitch, I'm going to Jack in the Box.
Yeah.
I'm going to Taco Bell.
And you know what else? You know what Pollo Loco doesn't have?
What?
People saying that there's pink slime in their chicken.
No, that's a myth.
Yeah.
That's never happened. But it was proven in an article by 3 scientists that went to Oxford. Fuck them. They can go to hell.
Yeah. Pollo Loco doesn't have all that bad press. McDonald's does.
That's true.
I'm going Pollo Loco.
Didn't Pollo Loco have like an Ebola outbreak at some point?
Fucking everybody did at one point.
I thought they did. I thought it was like a big thing with them, but
I don't know.
Oh no!
No, that was Chipotle.
Chipotle. Yeah. There we go. What is that?
Look at that. Pollo Loco's clean.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm going Pollo Loco.
Damn.
I'm going Pollo Loco.
Bye.
Where's she going? Bolarama?
No, that's Madi.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
She came here while...
Oh, they all sound the same to me, except Adri.
True. yeah, I guess I could go with Pollo Loco for sure.
Yes.
Like, McDonald's, you put me in the hospital twice, fuck
that
off.
That should have been the deciding factor there.
That's true. I was just trying to help it out, man.
Oh, okay.
I'm making a good show here.
The nail in the coffin is they sent Chris to the hospital twice.
Twice.
And once I had to go take him.
Yeah. And then he got CB thanks to McDonald's chicken nuggets. All right, let me put my wiener away.
Yeah, for real. All right, here it comes. This is the finals. Carl's Jr. versus El Pollo Loco. Who would have thought that Pollo Loco would have gotten this far?
Yeah, seriously. Like, looking at it, they're like the orange fucking crush.
Yeah, this is Orange Nation all over again.
Orange Nation all over again coming in for the Mexicans. At El Pollo Loco.
Yeah, so let's recap real quick. Carl's Jr. had to beat out In-N-Out. They had the first beat out Taco Bell.
Okay.
And then they fought against In-N-Out.
Ooh.
Pollo Loco had fucking really strong competition. The Habit, which won the undercard tournament. And then they also beat out McDonald's.
Damn.
McDonald's.
McDonald's.
So here it comes. Carl's Jr. versus El Pollo Loco for the finals for the King of Fast Food.
So I'm going to start off with this.
Okay.
King of Fast Food. I'm leaning towards Carl's Jr. at this very beginning point.
And why is that?
Because I don't know. I just like...
Because I'm a man and it's a man's fucking thing.
No, let's not put that out there because you're the one that said it. No, I'm just kidding. At the end of the day for me, but not at the end of this discussion, I just whenever I think of which one to get, I'm going to go more towards Carl's Jr. For me, I don't go out of my way to get El Pollo Loco. I'll go out of my way to get Carl's Jr. The times that I get El Pollo Loco, and like you mentioned earlier, is when it's nearby.
When was the last time you had Pollo Loco? Was it that time that we were leaving the gym and I bought you a bowl?
Mm-hmm.
Which was last month, I think.
It might have been because I've had it twice that I could remember. First and foremost, that time that we went and got those bowls right next to the gym.
Yes.
Right next to the gym. The next time that I remember getting it, it was either before that or after, when I was at work. Now, my work is on, what is it? Basically next to Belmont. And on Belmont, like a block down, it's El Pollo Loco. So I just drive down the street where that fucking, and right there, El Pollo Loco is right there. And I was like, you know what? This is pretty healthy. I'll get that.
Okay.
So honestly, I feel like I've never gone out of my way to get El Pollo Loco. And usually, you know, growing up, it was usually my mom would get it or something like that and get all the fucking chicken and shit like that. And it's like really good.
Yeah.
But that's kind of like where I'm at with that. I've never gone out of my way to get a Pollo Loco.
There's also a lot more Carl's Jr. than there are Pollo Loco.
Yeah.
Going down Black. Okay, let's just go down Blackstone. Starting from where Community Hospital's at, there's one right there. There's a Carl's Jr. there. And then you go all the way to, I think it's on Gettysburg. There's one there. And then you go all the way to... No, wait. There's one on McKinley right next to City College.
Yeah.
So there's two. Yep. And there's Gettysburg. There's three. And then there's one by Herndon. I think it's all right on Herndon. There's four. There's four just right there on Blackstone.
Damn.
Pollo Loco has one on Ashland and then one on Sierra. So that's two. So see?
Damn.
They got the locations.
The location. And there's a few on Shaw as well for Carl's Jr.
Yeah. There's easily more because I can only think of one. Pollo Loco on Shaw, which is the one next to the gym right there on Clovis.
True.
Shaw and Clovis. And which there's a Carl's Jr. right there on Shaw and Clovis too. okay, let's talk about food though, because that's really what it's all about.
Yep.
What a hamburger is all about, that's but In-N-Out's dead, so they can't say it anymore. what do you think is the more satisfying food, a double chicken bowl or a superstar with cheese with the fries and the drink?
Superstar with cheese.
What do you think is the more economic one? Big Carl meal or a chicken avocado salad or whatever the fuck.
I don't know how much a chicken avocado salad is.
How much? Okay, well, I don't know either, but what's like the general price for that everywhere though?
About $5, right?
I was going to say more.
Oh, it's like $6-$7.
Because it comes in that taco bowl.
The puffed out tortilla. And then a Big Carl, they usually have like a $5 one, right?
I think for the meal, it's maybe like $7-$8.
Okay.
But for the taco thing, I think it's closer to like $9-$10.
Damn.
Because you got to pay for the health. That's why.
Right.
You pay more for healthy.
Well, okay. So we're talking food, obviously. Now, here's the thing that will set it apart for me and will give me a Carl's Jr. vote is now we basically put in and continue to push a Pollo Loco for their chicken. But Carl's Jr. has some of the best chicken tenders I've ever had.
Hand-breaded chicken tenders.
It takes like an extra 5 minutes, but it's worth the fucking wait.
I will say this. I've only had it one time, and it's when they first came out. They were really good. I think the only thing I was surprised by is that it came in like the white box instead of like a Carl Jr. box.
Oh, okay.
You know, it came in just like a regular white box that you'd get at like a, you know, mom and pop kind of place, which kind of threw me off.
Yeah, they like, give you those in the box, yeah.
Yeah, but I was like, this is really good.
I mean, at the end of the day, if
we go with the end of the day stuff again.
Yeah, I know. At the end of the day, I could literally get a burger and like a 3-piece chicken tender.
Ooh.
And I would be more than satisfied, probably dead.
Mm-hmm.
But
probably dead.
I mean, honestly, I don't really feel like there's a big push from a Pollo Loco for me at this point because, you know, if I want to get chicken, I could literally just go to Carl's Jr. and get either a grilled chicken or their breaded chicken.
I wouldn't get the grilled chicken.
You don't like the grilled chicken?
No, it is not good.
I've only had it once, and I think it was like the teriyaki
burger. Crispy chicken one, though, on the other hand, is really good.
Oh, yeah, that's not bad.
That one's good.
But that one's because it's more cheap and
yeah.
You like cheap food.
Yeah, as far as chicken, though, grilled, obviously, Pollo Loco wins.
Yeah.
Fried, Pollo Loco doesn't even have fried chicken.
I thought they did.
Nope, it's all grilled chicken.
So it's at one point they had fried and grilled, didn't they?
I don't think so, but they don't have that now.
Mm.
It's all grilled.
Because
their whole catch is like you could taste the grill. That's their whole like tagline thing.
Yeah, but I thought they had like a promotion going on where it was like grilled versus, you know, like you can get the grilled or you can get it fried or something.
That's
like
KFC.
That.
Because you can get half and half in the bucket. Because that's when they came out with their grilled chicken.
I'm gonna have to look. I have to look. Just to make sure. Okay. El Pollo Loco fried chicken. All right, let's see.
He's looking on the computer.
Doing his work. They had some chicken tenders.
Huh. How long ago was that, though?
I can't really tell.
Probably a long time.
It has this guy that says peep this out, so it might be a long time.
Peep?
Peep?
Oh, yeah. That's late 90s, probably.
Late 90s?
Yo, dog. Peep this.
Peep this, son. Yeah, I guess they really didn't have
I think I'll end with this, is that, like, Pollo Loco is like, positioning themselves now as a more healthy alternative.
Okay.
With obviously the grilled chicken and pretty simple ingredients.
Yeah.
You know, beans, rice, and veggies.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, Carl's Jr. has kind of pretty much stayed the same, where it's like, hey, you know, you want a big fucking hamburger? You want some good ass fries? You don't want fries? We got onion rings. We'll give you that too.
Yeah.
What's that? You want those onion rings and a big fucking hamburger with barbecue sauce and bacon? Fuck it, come to us, man. We got you. We got the hookup. Big Papa Pump's got the hookup.
Big Papa Pump got the hookup.
Holler if you hear me. So, yeah, with all that said, I think that Carl's Jr., for the amount that you pay, the amount of food that you get, the selection of what goes in the fucking hamburger, because, I mean, you could throw, like, jalapenos and shit in there, too.
Yeah.
And as far as the availability, there's a lot more Carl's Jr.'s than there are Pollo Loco's, whether it be a Hardee's or a Carl's Jr. You're getting a big-ass fucking drink of, you know, whatever, Dr. Pepper or Hi-C or whatever.
Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde, yeah.
Yep. And, yeah, I think Carl's Jr. is getting a good vote.
Yeah. Yeah, honestly, I don't even feel bad about this, but I in my eyes, Carl's Jr. is, like, the king of fast food.
Yeah, and you know what? Okay, we'll just say it right now. Carl's Jr. is the winner.
Okay.
But I mean, we can't take anything away from Pollo Loco because I don't think we even thought they would get this far.
No. They're like Orange Nation, man. Yeah.
For
like,
what it is, a Pollo Loco is a pretty damn good fast food place.
Yeah.
They're the queen.
Yeah. Indeed. Yeah.
They're the queen of restaurants.
Yeah. I would absolutely
agree with that. Or the Jack, whatever the fuck. Who knows?
But no, yeah. I would absolutely agree with that. Pollo Loco has great quality. Their chicken is so fire, and you know, again,
because they cook it with fire.
And again, you know, to mention the the mashed potatoes, macaroni and cheese, so fucking good.
Hell yeah,
I definitely like that a lot. But yep. Carl's Jr., welcome in.
Yep. So here we go. Carl's Jr. is officially here on the Good Times Podcast, the king of fast foods.
Damn.
And damn it, I want a big Carl now.
It sounds so good.
It does.
Fuck.
Oh, man. Well, I think we could wrap it up here. It was a pretty good show. A lot of good debates. And you're probably hungry listening to this show.
Yeah.
So,
unless you just ate. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, so we'll wrap it up here. Executioner, where can they find you on the social stuff?
So first and foremost, before we go, as per usual, I'd like to thank Yeshua for allowing me to do this. And I also wanted to give a big birthday shout out to RJ, one of our very loyal listeners. He is the fan of the week. Fan of the week! Fan of the week! I have to throw that in. I haven't done that in a while. Yeah, shout out to RJ. He's always like messaging us, hey, where's the podcast? Hey, where's the podcast? Hey, where's the podcast? So yeah, shout out to you, RJ. You're fucking awesome. So if you're looking for me, all you have to do is go to Twitter at The Executioner, THEXEKUtioner, or you can go to, I almost said Twitter again, Instagram, where you can find me at The_Herbalutioner, THE_HERBALutioner, or you can find me on Facebook, Chris Clips Hernandez, CLYPSE is how you spell clips. You can hit me up on Snapchat if you'd like, DATDUDE. 1215, dat dude, 1215. And yeah, that's all you can find me on, unless you want to come knock on my door, which you better not, damn it. What about you, Jack? Where can they find
you? I thought I heard someone knock on your door. you can find me on Twitter, Snapchat, and Instagram, all at the same thing, BSALSANCHEZ. And don't forget to follow the show's Twitter, at It's Good Times. Also, don't forget to follow the show's Instagram, thegoodtimespodcast.com, where we post up clips of the show that are shareable, so you can send them out to people.
Yeah.
And anything else? I think that's about it, right? Thank you for listening to the show. Don't forget to subscribe, listen to the show, and also past episodes. New episodes drop every Thursday, so remember to tell your friends that they drop every Thursday.
Damn right.
And like we say here on the show, tell a friend, tell a foe, tell a pimp, tell a hoe, and tune in next week where we'll have another jam-packed pit, lick, and dick episode of Good Times. Turn.